Welcome to Adventures with Pinny.
We're in Tuscany, Italy for a few days for our friend's wedding, and we have some time to explore the area and eat as much food and drink as much wine as we possibly can.
Hopefully within limits. I don't want to get too fat.
We made it to Florence. We're here. The train took like an hour and a half. I slept through half of it, but the views I did see were gorgeous. So now we are going to walk over to our rental car company, Tuscany by Car, pick up our Fiat convertible, and then figure out how to drive.
You don't have to figure out anything.
Peter can figure out how to drive, and we'll make our way over to Pisa.
Yay!
You're doing great so far.
I've missed 5 turns. I've been honked at twice. I don't know if I'd call this doing great.
You're doing great. We're not dead.
Also, the car has no pickup. I've tried to like stomp on the gas to get out of somebody's way, and it's just like...
We're basically driving a Vespa.
Pretty much.
Pray for us.
We just need to get out of the city.
Yeah.
This is all going horribly. I don't see no Leaning Tower yet.
Yeah, me neither, but I don't think it's actually that tall, you know what I mean?
Yeah, probably like about 11 stories.
Yeah. Excellent. Scoozy.
Yep, it's definitely leaning. Right now we are walking to go try and get tickets so that we can go all the way to the top of the tower. Hopefully it won't fall on us. That'd be a really disappointing end to our short trip.
Smaller in here than I was expecting.
This is so cool.
If you want to see our entire experience climbing to the top of the Leaning Tower of Pisa, we actually made a separate video so we could take you along start to finish. We also share details and tips to help you plan your own visit to this iconic tower, so make sure to watch that next. I'll link it in the description down below.
We made it to the top of the tower. Check it out. Such an amazing view. Worth it for the steps, I guess.
Great view of Pisa.
Everything you could ask for.
We climbed all the way to the top, way up there.
It was awesome. Straight. We went to the top, and now we're gonna go to the villa.
Bad boy, we cruised so many Italian countrysides.
Now, to continue our journey, we're off to the hills of Tuscany. Let's go. Get in. Peter's so confident in his driving now. He's a regular Italian.
It's true, there was some dumb tourist not knowing where to go. And I had to weave by him. I only know because it happened to me this morning.
Yeah, that was you this morning.
But I've graduated.
Absolutely incredible. Over 100 years old, was a farmhouse, and they renovated it, but you can still see all of the old architecture in this brickwork, and it's just like something out of a magazine. I love it.
First off, Vespa tour.
Ah, yeah.
All through the hills of Tuscany. Tuscany.
Say your last words. There it goes.
We booked our Vespa tour through Ariana and Friends, and our tour guide Luca was incredible. Obviously, Peter drove while I got to be passenger princess. Luca took us down plenty of winding roads, past vineyards, and we even stopped at the famous Theater of Silence.
That's Volterra, way on top of the hill, king of the valley.
Wow, I was trying to give you a kiss. There, that's nice. Well, there we go. Welcome to Tuscany.
Welcome to Adventures with Pinny. Vroom vroom.
Let's do this.
This Vespa tour was such a blast and definitely one of the highlights of our time in Tuscany. I'll link the tour we did below, along with some other top-rated tours that include wine tasting, lunch, one that starts in Florence. There's a ton of options.
Here, let me do it.
Fabio.
Slow-mo, but you gotta get the coming off.
Oh, yeah.
So it's...
Wait.
Thing about our car, it's a convertible.
Aw, yeah.
So cute.
Check it out.
Back at the villa, that night was our friends' welcome dinner kicking off their Tuscany wedding weekend. Dinner was catered featuring pizza cooked in the villa's original 100-year-old wood-fired oven. And in case you were wondering, it was delicious. Today was the day. The ones who brought about this trip to Tuscany, our dear friends Matt and Alicia, were getting married. We were a little worried when some dark clouds rolled in right before the wedding ceremony. But it ended up only adding to the epic scenery. A moody, dramatic backdrop overlooking the Tuscan hills.
Oh my gosh, my heart's racing still. It was all so perfect and so magical, and we're in Tuscany right now, and I'll see you soon on the dance floor.
Cheers.
So pretty.
The thing about our friends is that they know how to throw a party. Plus, we all love to dance, and the Chianti Classico didn't hurt either. So naturally, we danced until 2 a.m., all jumped in the pool, and then danced some more. It was the perfect ending to a beautiful day in Tuscany.
Today we're in Volterra.
Yeah, we had a free afternoon, and so we took a easy 20-minute drive up the hills. Very windy, very curvy. It's a good thing we have a small car, but now we're on the hunt for Edward Cullen and the vampires.
Volterra sits on the top of a hill, which has incredible views of the Tuscan hills and surrounding area, but it's also just like super old, tons of really beautiful old buildings, and
known for its alabaster.
It has olive wood and leather goods and stuff.
So I bought a wallet.
You did. So we're just walking around, exploring the city a bit. Nothing's planned.
Except for gelato.
Except that.
That's where we're going right now.
Yeah.
Gelato. Here it is. Our first Italian gelato.
What flavor?
Limone.
How is it?
Oh, it's so good.
Do you recognize any of this from Twilight? I don't yet, but it's been a while since I've seen the movie. Edward may have been standing right over there, sparkling. While we're in town, we're gonna do some souvenir shopping because why not? And one of the things that Volterra is known for is alabaster. So let's check it out.
He's very sad at me. I told him we didn't need any more olive wood things.
I'm gonna use this to thank you.
Oh, don't tempt me with a good time.
Check out this view.
So beautiful. Overlooking all of Tuscany.
For our lunch in Volterra, we got a wild boar ragu pasta and a cheese plate, which has some different like local cheeses and stuff we're excited to try. Let's try wild boar. I don't know how to describe it, but it's good. Volterra was super cool, and we definitely recommend stopping by if you're in the Tuscany area. We had a ton of fun walking around, and we hope that we can come back someday and buy some more souvenirs because they had some great stuff and great views.
Lenny needs more olive wood.
Morning. Today is our last day in Tuscany. We got up super early and are driving back to Florence, and that's why we look super tired right now. But we've been enjoying watching the sunrise over the hills of Tuscany. It's been absolutely gorgeous, and we've had such an amazing time here. We can't wait to visit again in the future, of course, and explore more and drink way more wine. But for now, make sure to subscribe to watch the rest of our videos in Italy. We're gonna be heading on to Pompeii and then Positano, so definitely subscribe so you don't miss that. Thanks for watching, guys. Ciao! Still pretty tired.
Wow.
Man, look at this guy. He's got a foreign whip. Driving the foreign. Are you going? You break it? We're headed on to Pisa. Oh wait, no, we did that already. I meant we're headed on to Pompeii and then Naples. Or wait, no. They see me rolling. They hate it.